This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to one of our native hickories that's a relative of pecan, and that is bitternut hickory. Bitternut hickory, like all of the hickories, has compound leaves that are alternately arranged, and the leaflets have a tendency to get larger toward the end of the leaf. The leaflets on bitternut hickory tend to be relatively narrow as compared to some of the other hickories, and typically has 7 to 9 leaflets on this large compound leaf. The bud on bitternut hickory can also help us with ID. If we get it out here in a little bit of sunlight, we can see that it's got a strong kind of sulfur yellow color on this elongated bud. And that's a good identification characteristic for bitternut hickory. That's unique to this species. The alternate leaves are held on relatively stout stems. One of the other characteristics for bitternut hickory is the bark. The bark on bitternut hickory is quite tight and light to silvery gray in color, and has this interlacing network of small ridges. And this is pretty consistent throughout the life of the tree. Bitternut hickory does produce hickory nuts, although they're quite small and rounded, and true to their name, quite bitter, and so even wildlife don't tend to prefer these nuts over some other species. The nut hull is quite thin and has a little bit of a wing where the sutures meet, and the nut itself is rounded and a very light shell color. So not highly preferred by wildlife, but nonetheless one of our faster growing hickories, and also produces some good fall color in terms of yellows and golds in many cases.